the Davis Cup. It has something to do with my favorite sport, tennis. And we are going to be having the Davis Cup here in Portland, Oregon. Compliments of my guest, who went out of his way, gathered a team, and got it going for us. And I want him to tell you all about how the Davis Cup is coming to Portland, and with Brian Parrott. Brian, tell
us. Lisa, well, it really is a team thing that we assembled a very strong bid, and we beat out 10 cities to host what is really the most prestigious team event in international tennis. This, honestly, is the Cup is 107 years old. It's got tremendous history, and it's really Wimbledon, the U.S. Open, and the Olympics combined, and that's really, it's the most exciting brand of tennis, really, in my opinion. It's a world competition now that started in 1900 with two nations, the United States and England, and it was put up by a man from St. Louis named Dwight Davis, and his mission was to avoid war and to have goodwill among nations as they get to know each other. Mm-hmm. It has grown through those years to 131 nations.
That compete in it. They get together at their own tennis team of their very best from their country, right?
Right. There are really four. This is a men's event. The women's event, in similar to this, started in 1960, called the Fed Cup. This one started in 1900, so the cup is 107 years old.
Oh my gosh.
It's really the holy grail for a tennis player. And the competition has got incredible history as the nations would battle for the right to hold the cup. In the history of Davis Cup, the United States has won it 31 mm-hmm. times, and they'll be going after the 32nd here in Portland at the Coliseum.
Won it 31 years?
31 years. The next closest nation is Australia with 28.
Uh-huh.
And then the next closest nation is France. And it's part of Davis Cup, is really with one player, mm-hmm. you can turn a nation into a Davis Cup champion.
I wonder with Federer in Switzerland, have they ever won it since Federer's been on the team?
Actually, Federer and his friend have played together. Federer didn't play this year, but he's played in the past, but they haven't won it. Because there's five matches in a Davis Cup tie. Two singles on Friday, three out of five sets, and then just like Wimbledon and the U.S. Open or the Grand Slams. Then there's a doubles match on Saturday, which the United States here in Portland will be represented by the number one team in the world, Bob and Mike Bryan.
Who are great, yeah.
The fantastic, the identical twins. Yeah. This caller is not just any caller. He happens to be somebody that played 12 ties, I believe, for the United States. And in 107 years, only 138 men have actually played Davis Cup.
Oh, my gosh. Now, why do you call them ties?
Well, there was a terminology that Tom might explain more, but it used to be that the challenge, if you had the cup, the rest of the world played off to challenge against the team that had it. And they called them ties. I believe that's where it came from. But anyway, a Davis Cup match is referred to as a tie. But this is a Davis Cup final.
And we're Tom has done this, Tommy?
Well, Tom has played for the United States, and 12, I believe, and it could be 13, but he's been on a championship team in 1972 with Stan Smith and with Eric Van Dillen in Romania in difficult conditions. But he also then became the captain,
uh-huh.
and he's the winningest captain in U.S. history with 18 victories.
Oh my God.
He's from Seattle, Washington, and I'm proud to say he's a friend and a teammate from Seattle U. Mr. Tom Gorman, welcome to the show.
Yeah, thanks. I have no idea why they call them ties.
Yeah.
You don't either? I'm Lisa Michaels. Thank you so much for calling in, Tom. I appreciate it. You don't have any pictures of Tom, do you?
Oh, yeah. No, Brian? There are pictures,
yeah.
of Tom.
You were doubles partners with Brian. What was that like, Tom?
It was pretty awesome. We wore ties during the match.
Did you really?
Yeah, we were. Brian always dressed up. Very proper in college.
Brian Parrott, are we still talking about the same guy?
The Irish humor is coming through. We were anything but proper. There is
okay, maybe we can do a close-up.
Tom Gorman,
it's right here.
This is a picture right here.
You could try it.
Where Tom was captain of a team that won in '92, and so that's Tom Gorman on the far would that be?
When did you first find out that Brian was trying to get the Davis Cup to come to the Great Northwest again?
Well, I think it was probably early on, because there's always the opportunity if the Americans would win, and you know, and they've had some bad luck, and in Davis Cup you need one or two good players, and you need for both of them to be healthy, and you need both of them to be playing well at the same time. And then I think where the Americans have really improved their team the last few years is adding the Brian twins to the mix, because they're almost guaranteed one win of the five matches, which is awesome as a captain.
Yeah.
Now, the only problem is there's always a danger that if Andy or James gets hurt, neither one of the Brian twins are really going to be a suitable singles player. So you're putting yourself into a little danger there, but so far they've all stayed healthy, and that's what you got to keep your fingers crossed.
Oh, wow.
Tom, you said to me, I caught Davis Cup fever watching him play.
Uh-huh.
Long time ago, but what you have said about Davis Cup, I'll say it's some of the greatest tennis or the worst tennis because let me let you explain it.
Well, there's so much pressure that's self-imposed and then only imposed by the entire country that you're representing. So it just depends on how serious you take that responsibility. And yeah, literally, I have seen guys play atrocious tennis, and I've seen other guys play quality of tennis that they never reached at any other time of their career. And unfortunately, we experienced one when I was a captain down in Paraguay. They had a player, and I would challenge anybody in the Portland area that's watching or listening right now, if they know who Hugo Chapecu is, or who he was, or who he will be. But the weekend that he played, he played as if he was Roger Federer, and he beat us single-handedly. In fact, a year later, when we were in Seoul, Korea, the tennis team there playing in the Olympics, we were ready to practice on a court, and a couple guys were on the court ahead of us, and we're wondering who are these guys, and it was Hugo Chapecu, and we didn't even recognize him then because we had seen him so infrequently. But he was able to reach that one zenith of his career over a weekend, and the entire country of Paraguay carried him along, and they still carry him on his shoulders. And it's so unique that way that it's similar to maybe what football players say when they play the Super Bowl, and that is every play, every single down, just like in tennis, every single point in Davis Cup has tremendous value and tremendous importance and tremendous pressure that sometimes guys just gag out there. I mean, it's like they can't even breathe. And then other time guys just go along with the rhythm of the crowd. Agassi, when he played on my teams, if we were in Argentina or Ecuador or Peru, you know, they'd have their drums and their, you know, the horns going, and he felt as if the rhythm was for him, and so he played with it. And so Andre just played awesome in Davis Cup match, and there are a few players that have had difficulty. So we are definitely hoping that the crowd is rocking and rolling at the Memorial Coliseum in favor of the Americans, and let's just make these Russians feel as if their backs are against the wall the entire weekend.
Oh, we've got to do that. I mean, there's nothing like playing for your country.